It is really under pressure, but you know, I think I just had to keep my standard up and keep scoring goals because I think that's what the team needs. You know.
All right. The last time around in the qualifying campaign, in the semi-final round, you were, as I said, leading goal scorer. Some crucial goals, obviously. How would you describe your performances in the Argentina tour in particular? You weren't on the scoring charts, but at the same time, you started every game and you know, obviously gearing up for Wednesday's game. How the preparations went for you?
Yeah, well, you know, I coming off, I picked up an injury, you know, niggling, but again, over it, you know, I just trying to get back to the, you know, full fitness. So, you know, by the time, you know, game coming, I'll be fine, so just keep doing my thing.
How do you prepare yourself for such a game? I mean, we're less than a week away from the match. We're in El Salvador right now. There's nothing else to think about. There's nothing. We're not in Trinidad. We're away from home. Right now, it's just about football. How do you get yourself ready for such a game?
Yeah, well, you know, you just reflect on your past games and the past times you played them. You know, I think, you know, we know this team pretty well. So I just think that, you know, the guys just had to come out and, you know, do their best. Put their heads down and, you know, work for each other. And I think, you know, when you work for each other, that will make it, you know.
Yeah, go back to Marvin Lee Stadium against El Salvador. One of your first goals at international level. El Salvador then to El Salvador now, maybe a different team. And so is our team as well. We're a little bit stronger. What do you expect from El Salvador, Wednesday?
Yeah, well, I think, you know, they're at home and most people don't like to lose at home. And, you know, we know these you know, sort of South American, these Spanish-speaking country play, you know, they have a sort of aggressive way. But, you know, we just have to just, you know, give them back the same kind of treatment. And I think, you know, we are better players on our foot than them. So we just have to just work hard and I think we will get results tomorrow.
What would be the key for the game itself, though? You expect us to go out there from the opening whistle? Not be too cautious and see if we can slow up the game from very early, or you think we should play things out and you know, try to see if we get ourselves into the game?
Yeah, well, I think the best thing, you know, really is just to, you know, stay strong at the back, you know. I don't think if we don't give away goals, I think most times we score goals, you know. So I think if we just play to our plan, don't give away anything cheaply, I think we'll come out with the result as we want.
This is going to be a chance for you to play with some players who are in form. Kenwin Jones at the moment. We've had Chris Burchell, who's fully match fit. He's been playing regularly. And some of the other guys have been coming off their regular appearances for their respective clubs. How you expect the team now to look against El Salvador? A couple of days only together as a full team, but at the same time, all our players should be up for it.
Yeah, well, I think the players know each other due to the little while that we are on each other, I think. They know their style. I think we style and their style ain't no different. So I think, you know, we play pretty good and I think that, you know, we will overcome this little hurdle and I think, you know, we gonna win this game and go back home and enjoy ourselves.
Alright, let's go to you on a personal note now. What is in line in store for Keon Daniel at the club level? We know you're unattached at the moment, but obviously there must be something in the pipeline. Anything that you can talk about?
Yeah, well, I'm just trying to confirm, you know, it have plenty other things, you know, around the MLS and, you know, in Turkey and certain places, Norway, and, you know, I just trying to, you know, finalize something with Wolverhampton in the championship, you know.
Yeah.
Like, I think I'm looking at the highest level first, you know, if not, you know, I take anything down the line.
The issue with Petrichin. So a lot of people have said that there's a little more to that story that, you know, probably didn't come out. And has that affected you, or how have you dealt with that situation?
Yeah, well, I think, you know, everything I'm for a reason, and I think, you know, I get over that. So I just trying to just, you know, put them in the past and, you know, forget whatever happened with them and just keep going. And as I keep going, I just get stronger and stronger.
A lot of people wouldn't know also that you're quite close to the Burton Sinclair. When we look back to the past, we realize that he's had a decent relationship, a very sort of father-figure relationship with Dwight York. And now you are somebody who I understand has been quite close with him. We know when you're on trips, you tend to obviously be in touch with him certain times. Tell us about that relationship with Mr. Sinclair.
Yeah, well, you know, I think that came from youth, you know, because since being 5, 4 years old, you know, I known him, you know, playing in the coaching school, and from then I grew right up, come around him, so, you know, he's really like a father figure to me, and I think he's a good man to be around, you know, because he always looked out for me and certain things, so I think I just want to just, you know, really give back to them, you know, and just try my best to make it, so, you know, things will come good in the down to earth way, you know, because from your four parents, you know, we grew up in this kind of one love way, so I think when you come there, everybody treated like family, so I think, you know, most times when somebody come there, they will enjoy it, you know, because it's something to be afraid of, you know.
Right. What is your work ethic like? Has that stemmed from your bringing in Tobago? How does Keon Daniel get himself ready, physically prepared, mentally prepared for football?
Yeah, well, you know, I lost my mom, you know, and I think she was one of my greatest inspirations, so I think I just flash back at her, and, you know, at nights I just sit and just reminisce, and I think, you know, that little reminisce kept me pretty strong, you know, because I think she taught me from young and things, you know, we talked, and I don't think, you know, they ever leave me, so, you know, I just keep reminiscing, keep going.
Who are some of the figures in your life right now who have stood by you, somebody you can depend on, that sort of solid as a rock sort of companion?
Yeah, well, you know, it have my brothers, you know, my sisters, because they really come like my mother to me, you know. My big brother, you know, he'll be always talking and, you know, teaching me more about life, and my father. You know, Alberto's there, you know, on the other end, you know, so I really just, you know, try to get in contact with them so, you know, we could talk and they keep me in a certain frame of mind. I think that works plenty much for me.
And your upbringing, we've read many stories, we've heard many stories about people like Dwight and how they've grown up in Tobago. How has it been like for you? Obviously, it hasn't been smooth sailing. And life in Tobago, it could be a leisurely walk in the park if you wanted to, but at the same time, it may not always be the smoothest walk. Tell us a bit about your past, coming as a footballer, as a youth in Tobago.
Well, you know, everywhere are good and bad, you know, so I just try to just keep on good track, you know, because as I said, you know, mom, Bert, you know, they've been around from birth in a sense, you know, so the little things that I learned, you know, my mom always tell me, you know, nothing good come easy, so you know, that motto will stick in my head, so I know, well, you know, no matter what trials and tribulations happen, you know, just keep going.
Mm-hmm. Manchester United, the appearance there for you, the time you spent there would have been like a dream come true. How has that helped you in terms of your footballing knowledge?
Yeah, well, you know, really and truly, you know, as a youth growing up, you know, knowing that certain players played through there, and, you know, Dwight played there, and as a Tobagonian, and I went there and see the lifestyle, because, you know, that really opened my eye to see the difference between, you know, we in the Western and they out there, you know, and I think it's just a little bit more commitment, you know, because of, you know, the money as well, you know, so I think that opened my eye to see plenty of things, and it made my football standard raise a bit, because I knowing that, you know, the level that these players had and what level I had at.
Alright, someday you hope to probably play against Manchester United, play at Old Trafford?
Yeah, well, you know, I think that would be any young footballer dream, is to play at the highest level, and I think that level that Manchester plays at, I think that's one of the highest levels. So, even though, you know, I would like to play with or against, you know, it doesn't really matter to me.
Great, thanks a lot, best wishes. Yeah.